Today we will start straight lines. In straight lines, some important problems we do today. First is circumcenter, then we will do orthocenter. Okay, so the topic is straight lines today's class. So today's topic is circumcenter. Okay, now what is circumcenter? The point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors. The point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a triangle is circumcenter. See, now what is circumcenter? We draw a triangle. Now A, B, C are the three vertices of a triangle. Okay, A, B, C are the three vertices of a triangle. So what is circumcenter? Note down, I dictate this. The point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a triangle is circumcenter. Okay, continue. It is denoted by the letter S. Okay, so and one more, next time you note down this. The circumcenter is equidistant from the vertices of a triangle. The circumcenter is equidistant from the vertices of a triangle. So now this is a triangle. Now what we do is, now we have three sides. Okay, so now we bisect these. Bisect means what? We divide the side into two equal parts. Similarly, we bisect AC also and AB. All the three sides here bisect AB. Okay. Now, all these bisectors will meet at one point. This point is known as circumcenter. All the bisectors will meet at one point. So, what is this point called? Circumcenter. And it is denoted by letter S. Okay, so this is the definition of circumcenter. And one more thing what you have written is, the circumcenter is equidistant from the vertices of a triangle. Circumcenter is equidistant from the vertices of a triangle. So here, equidistant means what? The distance from S to A is equal to the distance from S to B is equal to the distance from S to C. The circumcenter is equidistant from the vertices of a triangle. That means SA is equal to SB is equal to SC. Okay, so this also you note down. Draw this triangle and note down this. Okay, this is the definition of circumcenter. Now we'll solve the problems on circumcenter. So this is very important problem in 1B. This will come for 7 marks. That is an essay question. Now we'll start the problem. See, problem. Find the circumcenter of the triangle whose vertices are 1, 3, -3, 5 and 5, -1. Now circumcenter means we need to draw a triangle. Okay, draw a triangle. It is ABC is a triangle. Now this represents circumcenter. Circumcenter is equidistant from all the three vertices of a triangle. So whenever we solve a problem on circumcenter, you draw this triangle. Now we'll assume the given points. So first one, let A is equal to the first point. What is the first one? It is 1, 3. And B is equal to -3, 5. And C is equal to, it is 5, -1. Now I am assuming the circumcenter S as x, is equal to x comma y. We are assuming the circumcenter S has x comma y. Now we have to find out this x comma y. Okay, its coordinate we have to find out. So to find this coordinate, what is the condition is, the circumcenter is equidistant from all the three vertices of a triangle. That means SA is equal to here. SA is equal to SD is equal to SC. So that will be a root here. This is the condition I want. Now, first I will take SA is equal to SD. That means now I will find out the distance between two points S and A and S to B. S to A and S to A. So distance between two points is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is SA is equal to under root of. Now I find out the distance from S to B, that is x plus 3 whole square, x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square. Okay. Now the roots get eliminated. We get x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square. Now after eliminating the roots, whatever we have written. Now expand this. So what we get? X square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square minus 6y plus 9. This is the expansion of a minus b whole square. This is also a minus b whole square. This is equal to, expand this, x square plus 6x plus 9. Okay, 2a, 3 plus 6x plus 9 plus y square minus 10y plus 25. So we expanded this. After expansion, we have some cancellation here. See, x square cancels on both sides, and y square cancels on both sides. After this, we what we do is, after this, we write x terms, y terms, and constant together. That means, see, first we have minus 2x. So any other x term throughout the line is yes. We have 6x. Transpose this side will become minus 6x. Then y terms, that is minus 6y. And here we have minus 10y. Transpose this side will become plus 10y is equal to numbers on the other side. Let's see. 25 plus 9 is 34. 25 plus 9 is 34. 9 plus 1 is 10. Transpose on the other side will become minus 10. Now after that, minus 2x minus 6x is minus 8x. Plus 10y minus 6y is plus 4y. Z equal to 34 minus 10 is 24. So you got this equation. Now from this equation, we can take 4 common. You take 4 common, what we get? 4 2's are 8, 4 1's are 4, 4 6's are 24. See, we took 4 common on both sides. So when we took 4 common on both sides, no need to write the 4. 4 2's are 8, 4 1's are 4, 4 6's are 24. So this we represent it as equation 1. So what is equation 1? Minus 2x plus y is equal to 6. Now we do SB is equal to SA. First we did SA is equal to SB. We got the equation. Now we do SB is equal to SC. Now we do SB is equal to SA. So now SB, the distance between these two points, that is S and B, under root of x plus 3 whole square, x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, it is y minus 5 whole square is equal to under root of sc, it is x minus 5 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square, x minus 5 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square. Now
So roots get eliminated x square, they want both sides. Now what we get is x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square is equal to x minus 5 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square. Now we expand this, that is x square plus 6x plus 9, a square plus 2ab plus b square, expand this. We are a minus b whole square, y square minus 10y plus 25, y square minus 10y plus 25 is equal to, x square minus 10x plus 25, square minus 10x plus 25. Now y plus 1 whole square plus y square plus 2y plus 1, y square plus 2y plus 1. Now we can cancel x square and x square on both sides, then y square on both sides. After cancellation we rearrange the terms. First x term 6x transposes 10x will become plus 10x. Then y terms, it is minus 10y. Here we have a y term, so write it as minus 2y. Then numbers. Okay, so I think here 25, 28 also we can cancel. Now we have constants as 1. Here we have 1 as base, and here we have a constant 9. Transpose on the other side, we get minus 9. So here we get 16x minus 12y is equal to minus 8. 16x minus 12y minus 8. Now from this equation clearly we can take 4 common on both sides. If I take 4 common, I get 4x minus 3y is equal to minus 2. 4 4s are 16, 4 3s are 12, 4 2s are 8. So minus 2. So this is equation 2. Now what is circumcenter? The point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors. So now this is a, see what is equation 1 called? Equation 1 is nothing but the equation of perpendicular bisector. What is this equation called? This is also the equation of perpendicular bisector. So now if I solve these two equations, if I solve 1 and 2, how will solve? By eliminating, by elimination method. If I solve equation 1 and 2 by elimination method, you can use substitution method or cross multiplication method. Any method you can use. I will use elimination method to solve. If I solve 1 and 2, I will get circumcenter. Now I will solve 1 and 2. Okay. Now we will solve 1 and 2. So I will write here. Solve 1 and 2. Okay. Now I will write equation 1. What is equation 1? It is minus 2x plus y is equal to 6, and equation 2 is 4x minus 3y is equal to minus 2. 4x minus 3y is equal to minus 2. So now to solve this, what I do, either I have to eliminate x term or y term, anyone you can eliminate. So what I do, I eliminate x term. So in order to eliminate x term, what I do, I will multiply the first equation with 2. I will multiply both sides of the first equation with 2. So if I multiply minus 2 into minus 2 is minus 4x plus 2y is equal to 12. Okay, is equal to 12. Then next, what we get again after this? This equation as it is. It is okay. So I will write it here. Minus 4x plus 2y, minus 4x plus 2y is equal to 12, and 4x minus 3y is equal to minus 2. See what I did is I multiplied with 2. I wrote there. So minus 4x plus 4x cancels. Okay, minus 3y plus 2y is minus y is equal to 12 minus 2 is 10. So what is y value I am getting? Minus 10. Y value is minus 10. To get the value of x, what we will do is, to get the value of x, substitute y is equal to minus 10 in equation 1 or 2. Anyone we can use. I'll substitute in equation 1. So I'll substitute in this equation. That is minus 2x plus y is equal to 6. Minus 2x plus y is equal to 6. Then minus 10 I'm substituting in this equation. So minus 2x minus 10 is equal to 6. So minus 2x is equal to, we get 16. See, when I transpose minus 10, it become plus 10. So it is 10, 6 plus 10 is 16. Then what is x is equal to? It is 16 by minus 2. 16 by minus 2, that is minus 8. So now we got y value as minus 10, x value as minus 8. So now what is circumcenter S? So S is equal to, S is equal to x comma y. What is x value? Minus 8. And what is y value? Minus 10. Okay, so this completes the circumcenter problem. So now we do a similar type of problem, circumcenter, then vertices are given. So A minus 2 comma 3, B 2 comma minus 1, C is 4 comma 0. So using these three, we have to find out circumcenter. So to find the circumcenter, what I do? I'll assume let S is equal to x comma y as a circumcenter. Now the condition for the circumcenter is SA is equal to SB is equal to SC, because the circumcenter is equidistant from the three vertices of a triangle. So the first one we have is SA is equal to SB. Okay. Now what is SA? It is under root of x plus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to SB. It is under root of x minus 2 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square. What is SA? It is x plus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square. And what is SB? X minus 2 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square. Now, we expand this. Now, we expand x plus 2 whole square. X square plus 4x plus 4 plus y square minus 6y plus 9 is equal to x square minus 4x plus 4 plus y square plus 2y plus 1. We expand. After expansion, x square gets eliminated, y square also gets eliminated. Now, x terms we write together. So, 4x, transpose this, it will become plus 4x minus 6y, and this will transpose, it will become minus 2y. Z equal to numbers, we have already 1 on RHS, transpose is 9, it is minus 9. So, we get 8x minus 8y is equal to minus 8. So clearly we can take 8 common on both sides, and no need to show that common term as we have common on both sides. So what we get? X minus y is equal to minus 1. This is equation 1. Now after getting equation 1, we'll do SB is equal to SC. Okay, see, SA is equal to SB, next we are doing SB is equal to SC. Or you can also do SA is equal to SC. Okay, either you do SB is equal to SC or SA is equal to SC. Anything is no problem. So now I am doing SB is equal to SC. So what is SB? Find the distance between two points. It is under root of x minus 2 whole square plus, x minus 2 whole square plus y plus 1 whole square is equal to SC. It is x minus 4 whole square, x minus 4 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square. X minus 4 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square. Now after expanding, now we'll expand this. So we get x square minus 4x plus 1, x square minus 4x plus 4, then y square plus 2y plus 1, expand this, is equal to, expand this, x minus 4 whole square, is equal to x square minus 8x plus 16 plus
y square.
Okay, so we expand. After expansion, again we eliminate the second unit terms. X square, y square, y square terms get cancelled. So you can cancel x square is equal to x square, y square is equal to y square. After cancellation, we recorrect those terms. X terms minus 4x plus 8x. Okay, plus 2y. We don't have y term on the other side. Only one y term. So that is 2y. Already we wrote. This is equal to 16. Okay. Now the constant on LHS is 4 plus 1, 5. Transpose that side. It will become minus 5. So we get 4x plus 2y is equal to 11. So this is equation number 2. So now to get a circumcenter S, x, y, we need to solve equation 1 and equation 2. So now what I do is see, what is coefficient of x in equation 1? 4. And what is coefficient of x in equation 1? See, coefficient of x in equation 1 is 1 and coefficient of x in equation 2 is 4. So I write these two equations. Solve 1 and 2. So first equation is x minus y is equal to minus 1, and here the other one is 4x plus 2y is equal to 11. So either you have to eliminate x term or y term. To eliminate x term, what I do, I multiply the first equation with 4. This is elimination method. So if we multiply, what we get? We get 4x minus 4y is equal to minus 4. 4x plus 2y is equal to 11. Now we subtract. When we subtract, we change the sign in the elimination method. Plus 4x minus 4x cancels. Minus 4y minus 2y will become minus 6y is equal to minus 11 minus 4 is minus 15. Okay. Now what is y value? Y is, you can cancel minus and minus, is 15 by 6, or y is equal to, you can eliminate this in 3 table, you can cancel this in 3 table. 3 5s are 15, 3 2s are 6. So what is the y value? It is 5 by 2. So now we find out x. Now what we do is substitute y is equal to 5 by 2 in equation. You can substitute in equation 1 or equation 2. I am substituting in equation 1. So what is equation 1? It is x minus y is equal to minus 1. X minus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 1. I substituted the value of y, 5 by 2. To get the value of x, x is equal to minus 1 plus 5 by 2. Minus 5 by 2, we transpose on the other side, plus 5 by 2. So x is equal to minus 2 plus 5 by 2. So what is x is equal to, we get 3 by 2. Now we want circumcenter. So what is circumcenter x comma y? X is equal to, first you are right, x value, that is 3 by 2 comma y value is 5 by 2. So here the circumcenter is 3 by 2 comma 5 by 2. So this completes the problem. See now, circumcenter problems you try these two problems as homework. The first one is A, 1 comma 0, B, minus 1 comma 2, C, 3 comma 2, and the other one is 1 comma 3, 0 comma minus 2, minus 3 comma 1. So try these two problems on circumcenter, very very important. See, one more problem on circumcenter. When the equation of sides is given, let me see, find the circumcenter of a triangle whose sides are 3x minus y minus 5 is equal to 0, x plus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0, 5x plus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0. Whose sides are given means what? Suppose you have a triangle. Okay, now in this triangle we put them as, we represent the vertices as ABC. They are given equation 1, equation 2 and equation 1, 2, 3, they are given. So now what we do is, first we consider those equations, we find out the vertices A, B and C. Okay, so first we'll write let. So what is the first equation we have? 3x minus y is equal to 5. Equation 1. And x plus 2y is equal to 4. Equation 2. And 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 1. This is equation 3. Now, what we do? We'll solve 1 and 2. So you can represent them 1, 2, 3. First I solve 1 and 2. Next I solve 2 and 3. Then I solve 3 and 1. Then I get all the 3 words. So first we'll solve 1 and 2. See, solving by elimination method. Okay. So solve 1 and 2. So when I solve 1 and 2, I just see the coefficient of x is 3. And here it is 1. To eliminate x term, I will multiply this equation with 3. Okay. So first equation as it is equal to 5, 3x plus 6y is equal to 12. And multiply with 3, 3x plus 6y is equal to 12. Now when we subtract minus, 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 these two get eliminated. Minus y minus 6y is minus 7y is equal to 5 minus 12 is minus 7. So y value is 1. See, y is minus 7y minus 7. So 7, 7 cancel, minus minus cancel, y value is 1. Now substitute y is equal to 1 in equations. We are solving 1 and 2. Either you substitute 1 or 2. Anyone you can use. And substitute 1. So what is equation 1? It is 3x minus y. What is y value? 1 is equal to 5. So 3x is equal to 5 plus 1, 6. So x is equal to 6 by 3. 6 by 3 is 2. So we got one point. What is that point we write? It is 1, 2. Right? After this, what we do is we will solve 2 and 3. So we are solving 2 and 3. Okay, so now before solving, I just take the x coefficients. Here x coefficient is 1 and here the x coefficient is 5. So what I do, I multiply the second equation with 5 so that I can eliminate x. So 5x plus 10y, 5x plus 10y is equal to 20. Then the third equation as it is, which is 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 1. So I am subtracting, so these two get cancelled. 10y minus 3y is 7y is equal to 21. Y is equal to 21 by 7. 21 by 7 is 3. So substitute y is equal to 3 in equation 2. Whether 2 or 3, anything you can use. So what is equation 2? It is x plus 2y. 2y, what is y value? 3 is equal to 4. Now x plus 6 is equal to 4. So x is equal to 4 minus 6. X is equal to minus 2. So we got one more point is minus 2 comma 3. It is minus 2 comma 3. And one more thing, very solid here. The point is not 1 comma 2. First we need to write x value, then we need to write y value. So the point is 2 comma 2. So this is the correction. It is 2 comma 1. Okay. So now here we got is minus 2 comma 3. Now after this, we'll solve 3 and 1. So when we are solving 3 and 1, just refer the x terms. X coefficient is 3. Here the x coefficient is 5. So to eliminate the x terms, I'll interchange the coefficients and I'll multiply. That means first equation I'll multiply with 5. First equation I'll multiply with 5. And third equation I'll multiply with 3. Why we have to do like that? To eliminate x terms. So interchange and multiply. The equation 3 coefficient, x coefficient is 5. I'm multiplying it to the first equation. And first equation x coefficient is 3. I'm multiplying to the equation 3. So with 5 I multiply this. 5 3's are 15. 5 1's are 5. 5 5's are 20. Multiply. Now this I multiply with 3. 3 5's are 15. 3 3's are 9. 3 1's are 3. So So if I subtract, this will get cancelled. Minus 9y minus 5y is minus 14y is equal to 28y. So y is equal to 28y minus 14. Y is, we get minus 2. 14 minus 14 is y value is minus 2. So substitute y is equal to minus 2 in equation. Either you use 1 or 3, anything you can use. I am using equation 1. So what is equation 1? 3x. 3x minus y. What is y? Minus 2. I am substituting minus 2 is equal to 5. So 3x plus 2 is equal to 5. 3x is equal to 3. 5 minus 2 is 3. So what is x is equal to? We are getting 3 by 3, 1. Now we got one more point. What is that point? Is 1 comma minus 2. Okay, we got 1 comma minus 2. Now after getting all these points, we put them as A, B, C as three vertices. S is equal to x comma y as a circumcenter. Now we find out circumcenter using the condition SA is equal to SB is equal to SA. So now we find out the circumcenter using the vertices 2 comma minus 1, minus 2 comma 3, 1 comma minus 2, and we are assuming the x comma y as circumcenter. Now the condition is SA is equal to SB is equal to SA. So first we take SA is equal to SB. What is SA? Distance between two points. That is x minus 2 whole square, x minus 2 whole square plus y minus of minus is plus y plus 1 whole square is equal to SB. It is x plus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square. Now expand this. X square minus 4x plus 4 plus y square plus 2y plus 1 is equal to x square plus 4x plus 4 plus y square minus 6y plus 9. We expand a plus b plus 1. A minus b plus 2. Then x square, y square cancels. Now x terms will be correct. Minus 4x, one more x term is here, minus 4x plus 2y and plus 6y. The 6y I am transposing to the other side, plus 6y. Then numbers, it is 4 plus 9 is 13. And here 4 plus 1 is 5 on the other side. So we get minus 8x plus 8y is equal to 8. Now I take 8 common on both sides, so I get minus x plus y is equal to 1. This is equation number 4. So already we have 1, 2, 3 from the question. This is equation 4. After this, what we have to do is we will do SB is equal to SC. So what is SB? Distance between two points. It is under root of x plus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to SC under root of x minus 1 whole square plus y plus 2 whole square. See, I am not writing the root, the reason is they get cancelled. So we expand this. That is, this clearly, if you expand what we get, it is x square plus 4x plus 4 plus y square minus 6y plus 9, then is equal to x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y square plus 4y plus 4. We expand. After expansion, x square cancels. So x terms will be like, let us see, 4x. Okay, 4x plus 2x, minus 2x transpose this side. Then minus 6y minus 4y is equal to 1 plus 4 is 5. And here 4 plus 9 is 13. Transpose on the other side, minus 13. Okay, so 4x plus 2x is 6x minus 10y is equal to minus 8. So I take 2 common from this. 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10, 2 4s are 8. This is equation number 5. Okay. Now, to get the circumcenter, we need to solve So solve equation 4 and equation 5.
So now, see what I do, this equation 4, I multiply with 3.
Okay, I multiply with 3.
So what we get is minus 3x plus 3y is equal to 3.
And equation 5 as it is, 3x minus 5y is equal to minus 4.
Now, plus 3x minus 3x cancels.
Minus 5y plus 3y is minus 2y is equal to minus 5.
Minus 2y is equal to minus 5. So, what is the value of y we get?
So, y is equal to 1 by 2. Because, see, you can cancel minus sign on both sides.
So, y is equal to 1 by 2. Now, we have to find the next value.
So, substitute y is equal to 1 by 2 in equation.
See, you can use equation 4 or 5. I am using equation 4.
In equation 4.
So, what is equation 4? It is
minus x plus y.
See, minus x plus y. But what is y we have?
1 by 2.
I am substituting that.
Plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1.
Minus x plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1.
So, minus x is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2.
Just transpose this constant on the other side.
Minus 1 by 2.
So, minus x is equal to 2 minus 1 by 2.
I put x here, 2 minus 1 by 2.
So, minus x is equal to,
So, x value is minus 1 by 2.
So, here the circumcenter what we got is minus 1 by 2 comma 4 by 2. Okay. Now, you please try this problem, circumcenter problem, when equation of sides is given. So, the equations are x plus y plus 2 is equal to 0, 5x minus y minus 2 is equal to 0, x minus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0. So, find the circumcenter for these three equations, okay? So, today's class is completed. Next class, we will do the problems on orthocenter, which is also very, very important. So, please practice the circumcenter problems. Thank you.